Poor air quality is the largest environmental health risk in the United States, killing more than 100,000 people each year. In fact, more people die because of air pollution caused by activities such as producing electricity, growing food, and driving on roads than die from car crashes and murders combined. But not everyone is equally exposed to poor air quality. Some people live near smokestacks, farms, or highways, while others live in areas with generally good air quality. Also, not everybody contributes equally to poor air quality. Pollution is released when we produce goods and services, so those who consume more tend to be responsible for more pollution. We asked whether there are differences in how racial ethnic groups are affected by and contribute to air pollution. In particular, we looked at fine particulate matter, also known as PM2.5, which is especially harmful because it leads to heart attacks, strokes, lung cancer, and other diseases. We tracked responsibility for air pollution using detailed information on the types and amounts of goods and services consumed by people in different racial ethnic groups, and on how much pollution is caused by that consumption. What we found is that Black and Hispanic minorities bear a disproportionate burden from air pollution, and that pollution is disproportionately caused by consumption of goods and services by non-Hispanic whites. On average, Blacks are exposed to about 56% more PM2.5 than they cause. For Hispanics, it is slightly higher, 63%. In contrast, non-Hispanic whites experience about 17% less air pollution exposure than what they cause. We find that this pollution inequity among racial ethnic groups is caused by differences in both how much people consume and in where people live. Differences in the types of goods and services consumed by different groups are less important to overall inequity. Overall, our study finds that the effects on different racial ethnic groups of recent efforts to improve air quality are mixed. The good news is that in the past decade, the air in the U.S. has gotten cleaner overall, even as overall consumption has increased, and all three racial ethnic groups have benefited from those improvements. However, over the same time, pollution inequity has remained high. Interested in learning more? Check out our article.